Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, as you know that we have studied about Boyle's law and now we are going to talk about a numerical which is based on Boyle's law. So let us do a numerical of that. So as mentioned on the screen, this is a numerical which is based on Boyle's law. So let us see the question and let us find out what is they are asking for. So first thing is that the volume of a given mass of a gas is 0.6 dm cube that they have mentioned at a pressure of 101.325 kilopascal. So we have to calculate the volume of gas if its pressure is increased to 142.86 kilopascal at same temperature. So how can we predict whether this numerical is based on Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac law or Avogadro's law? The thing is, we could easily predict. Here you could see that this is a numerical which is based on Boyle's law. So for example, suppose in your exam, suppose it comes, and how can you predict whether it is a numerical which is based on Boyle's law? In this case, as you could see that the temperature is being same or the temperature is being constant. So this indicates that among the laws that we have studied, that is for Boyle's law, Charles' law and Gay-Lussac law. So among those laws, in this case only, that is the at same temperature, means the constant temperature has been given. So basically they are being mentioning about the Boyle's law itself. As well as here we could see that the pressure value is being given as well as the volume is also being mentioned in the numerical. So therefore they are basically talking about Boyle's law. So the first thing that we are going to do in this thing is we are going to extract the data and let us see what is the thing that they are asking about. So the given data that they have provided to us is, the first thing that they have provided us is the volume of a gas in a particular condition, that is for a particular pressure. So I could write it as the initial volume, I have named it as V1. As something that they have given to us, that is 0.6 dm cube. So 0.6 dm cube is the initial volume at a pressure of that, even that is been mentioned with us, to us, that is 101.325 kilopascal. So this is what they have mentioned. And what they are asking is for that we have to calculate the volume of gas if its pressure is increased to 142.86. It means the and yes, and in this case the temperature is also being constant, so therefore we have to calculate the V2, that is we have to calculate the volume if the pressure is now being increased to, that is 142.86 kilopascal. So we have to find out the volume, what would be the volume of that particular gas at constant temperature. So in this case, as you know that the pressure and volume are being mentioned and the temperature is being constant. So this clearly indicates that we are talking about Boyle's law. So let us see what is Boyle's law actually. So we know that the Boyle's law states that pressure is inversely proportional to volume. You know, and we have derived this thing also. So we could easily mention that P1 is inversely proportional to V1, as well as P2 will be inversely proportional to V2. And since the both are being taking place at constant temperature, so I could evaluate a formula like P1, which is being inverse to that of the volume. So I could write it in this way, that is V1 is equals to P2 V2. So this is the formula on basis we are going to calculate what will be the basically volume of the gas and that pressure. So it is very much easy to find it out. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to substitute the values that have been given to us in this formula. So for P1, they have provided us, that is for P1, I would write it in this way, that is 101.325 kilopascal. So I could mention in kilopascal also, I could mention in pascal also, but the thing is that both the pressure are being given in kilopascal. So therefore I could write it in this manner only, that is for kilopascal. I don't have to convert for kilopascal, but I could do in pascal also, but that doesn't matter now. So I will multiply it by the volume, that is for V1 that they have provided us is 0.6, And then of the P2 that they have provided us, that is the second pressure that they have provided us, that is the final pressure, that is nothing but 142.86. And we have to calculate what will be the value of P2. So therefore, we could write it as the P2 will be, I'll make it in this way, that is 101.325 multiplied by 0.6, the whole divided by 142.86. So if I calculate this thing, then let us see what is the answer we could get. So we have got an answer as the P2 is basically 0.42. But now the unit of this would be dm³. So this is the answer basically. So V2 is 0.4 dm³, and as we could easily predict that when the pressure was, that is an initial pressure, it was around something 101.325 kilopascal, and the initial volume, which was basically 0.6 dm³, and now the pressure that they have provided to us is P2, that is the final pressure that they have provided us, is 142.86 kilopascal. And now for the volume that we have got for P2 is nothing but 0.4 dm³. So in this case, what we are observing is that if the pressure is less, when we are comparing this both two, if the pressure is less, then the volume will be increased. So this indicates that pressure is inversely proportional to volume. And here also, if we have studied that if the pressure was more, that is 142 is more than 101.325. And if the pressure is more, then the volume will be less. So in this case, the volume is 0.42, which is less than 0.6. So this clearly indicates that this is following Boyle's law, that's true. But it also indicates that if we increase the pressure, then the volume will be reduced. And this is nothing but the Boyle's law. So this is how we have calculated the answer. And so thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you are going to do this kind of numericals in your future also, and try to solve more and more so as to get your doubts clear when it comes to Boyle's law and numericals depending on the Boyle's law. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe to eGrita channel. Thank you so much.